Hello everybody, I'm Max Relix alongside the four-time NEW World Champion Owen, and we welcome you to NEW Brawl.
Nightmare before New Year, fast approaching. We are looking for our contenders for the title matches there. Rick Weaver now number one in the rankings, surpassing Tasmania, who'd been holding that number one spot for a while. Wanted to make note of that. Some summit action continuing here tonight. Team 2 are taking on Team 4 in the 2v2 elimination.
Yeah, traditional tag team rulings. We've also got a match in the women's division that could be a crucial one at that. Nancy Valentine goes one-on-one versus Melissa Sanchez. And then of course they're in that injection division number one contender.
Yeah, that rematch from a couple of weeks ago. Of course we saw Tyler York and Sean O'Grady duke it out and it ended up as a draw. So tonight we have sudden death thrown into that main event should we need it. But here we look at the remaining teams in Summit. We're down to three.
Yeah, and that, you know, we've had some huge names already knocked out of this tournament, and as you say, Erwin, only three teams remain, so we really are getting to the business end of this tournament. You know, arguably the biggest prize we offer here in NEW, it's essentially a blank piece of paper. You can pretty much ask for anything, and you know, within reason, you're pretty much going to get it.
And of course, Fox and Nancy Valentine being the remaining female competitors, they already have that. I think we all know that they'll be after those singles gold that they lack to become Foxy Four Belts. Of course we're waiting for that confirmation.
Well, much has been made, Erwin, about the almost telepathic connection that Carl Abbott and Lobo Mysterioso seem to have formed as a tag team. They've never tagged before this summer tournament, and there's been much speculation about whether or not they're going to continue as a tag team after this tournament, because well, they just seem to be such a natural fit together. And who would have thought it, like a big bruiser like Carl Abbott and an enigma like Lobo Mysterioso, but for whatever reason it works.
It does indeed, but arguably they would still have a third man if Eli Ward hadn't have taken that count out.
Yeah,
the last time there.
Yeah, well, I think, you know, there's definitely going to be some fallout from that from the Jones gang, so we're going to have to wait and see. I mean, yeah, we've seen some pretty nasty kind of reactions from the likes of the Reaper in the past, so
we did see them all sort of start fighting each other after that. But either way, it left Carl Abbott and Lobo Mysterioso down to two. Team 4 arguably have the advantage here tonight, as they have an extra man in reserve should things not go well for them here.
But before this tournament, Erwin, I don't think we'd really seen Lobo Mysterioso a lot in in-ring action. And if Summit has done anything, it is confirmed that this guy just truly is just a natural talent. You know, forget all the backstage antics, forget all the disciplinary issues, because there have been many of both. When he gets inside that ring, he is pretty damn impressive, and like, I do genuinely believe here in terms of the men's division that he could be the one to watch.
You may be right. Lomo Mysterioso has certainly carved a forceful patch here in NEW already. Never even considered the possibility of him entering the tag division really until the Summit. That may have crossed Lobo's mind as well.
Well, I believe if Mysterioso wins this thing, I think he'll be looking at either the European title to try and basically confirm his spot as the number one luchador in this company. Obviously he would have to beat Juan Gonzalez for that title as it stands right now, or he's going to go straight for the world. But I don't know, it's really hard to tell with Lobo Mysterio. So when you think you've got him pinned down and figure out, he'll go left and go a completely different direction.
And that is part of what's made him such a tough opponent in that ring. Misdirection and adaption.
Just a natural raw talent, as controversial as they get, but undoubtedly one of the very best on NEW's books. Carl Abbott, no slouch either. That could be a hell of a team, Irwin, if they actually go down that road together.
Well, it certainly sounds and looks like the Reaper's done with the Jones Gang.
Yeah, no music different. Well, there's a music different, excuse me, no white trunks, which has been the Jones Gang's colours. Very much more a traditional kind of Reaper look. This guy really does need to try and find the form that he had when he first came into this company, when he was pretty much damn near unstoppable.
Yeah, that insane title to title run that he had. And well, both members of Team 4 here tonight, on their best day, are unstoppable.
Yeah,
both have been questioned as to whether their best days are behind them.
Yeah, but I don't think I could really dispute that comment, Irwin. I mean, obviously Cowboy Roy, I'll let Roberto do his thing here. Yeah, I mean, a few weeks ago, of course, Paul Masters shocked the world when he beat Cowboy Roy, but, you know, the Cowboy kind of owned that defeat. He didn't try and shy away from it. He pretty much admitted to me backstage that on the day, Paul Masters was just simply better. But that will bother the veteran, I can guarantee you that. And he will want to make amends as quickly as possible. He's still very much alive in this tournament, and no one can disrespect this man. No one can doubt his intentions. He said he wanted to do it the hard way. He wanted to prove that he could hang with the best that we have. And he, as I have said to you on a few occasions, Irwin, I truly believe that his stature and his record in NEW would have entitled him to a title shot. But he didn't want to go that way. He wanted to earn it, as is tradition here in NEW. It's incredibly hard to get a title shot in this company, and Cowboy Roy decided to do it the hard way.
Part of me still hopes that this is a bit of a slump for Roy, if you will, in his record.
But everyone has them, you know, the best of all time have all had those slumps.
Oh, certainly.
And you are right, Irwin, on his day, he's as dangerous as he's ever been. And the question remains, is today his day? We're going to find out, because this is going to be a close run affair for hard-hitting, intense individuals. 30 minutes on the clock, Shatopa rings the bell, look at the flashbulbs, and here we go. Boom! Good start by the Reaper.
Yeah. Caught Cal Abba off with his own weight, changed that momentum. Oof! Headbutt there from Abbott. shook the Reaper off. Up on the shoulder, draped over that top rope. The fury everyone has brought to this summit tournament.
I think, you know, the intensity of this tournament can really be explained by the prize, because it is, as I said in the introduction, essentially a blank piece of paper. Within reason, this is arguably...
Congratulations already from the Reaper.
This is actually could be a really good way to try and get one of these guys out, a submission. You know, there's very little your opponent can do, or your partner for that matter, because of the gaze of the referee.
Strength of habit, just scooping the Reaper up.
We do really need, at some point, a hoss fight between all our big guys to actually determine who is the strongest one, because it's ridiculous. We've got some monsters here in NEW right now.
Really do at the moment. In the land of giants. Oh! Reaper just struggling against the power of Abbott here.
There are armies that will struggle against the power of Abbott. It's ridiculous. This guy is farm strong. Very much like Cowboy Roy, of course. Carl Abbott from the Highlands in Scotland, caber tossing before he became a wrestler, so a Highlands game participant in his past. He's a ridiculously strong man.
The Reaper sent hard into that barricade. Carl Abbott just showboating. Count of seven might lead this to a count out, but the Reaper back to his feet.
Yeah, I mean, we have seen that on that one occasion with Eli Wodge electing to take that count out, so don't say it isn't possible. I mean, you know, as you said, Erwin, during the introduction, that's why the Reaper and Roy are effectively the last men in their team.
Which Abbott and Lobo.
Excuse me, Abbott and Lobo, excuse me. Yeah, which is by the only the last two men in that team. And of course, that led to the conflict between the Jones gang. Reaper wearing his own colours here tonight, so we can only speculate what that means. Oh! Disrespectful slap there by the Cowboy. By Abbott, excuse me, Jesus.
Scooped.
Tag mate.
Roy.
I'll get there eventually, folks, my word. Here we go.
Well, more of the new blood with my there. Put Roy on edge. Bit of a fan there by Lobo Mysterio. So,
well, you know, you've been in that situation, Erwin. Obviously, you know, you're former world champion, and you must have been in that situation when you were getting to like the tail end of your career and all these hot prospects coming into that locker room. I mean, what is that like for a veteran?
Oh, it's tough. It's tough to try and keep up the pace with the new blood. That hunger of something they've not had yet. Compared to that hunger of wanting it again. Oof.
And of course, all these young bucks want to prove that point, which puts the target on the likes of the Cowboys back. Carl Abbott would dearly love to add that scalp to his growing collection. Oof. Hard forearm shot there by the Cowboy.
Oh, and a big bulldog.
Still widely acknowledged as the hardest right hand in the business, as Roy.
Hard shots by the Reaper here. Showing him some strength of his own. Just manhandling Carl Abbott now. Fists. Drags him back over to his team's corner, closer to Roy, isolating him from Lobo Mysterio. So Carl Abbott now in trouble.
Yeah, classic tag team tactics here, alienating one opponent in the corner. I am quite surprised that the Reaper is elected to try and do this with Carl Abbott, who's obviously the bigger of the two men in his team. Going for a pin here, Shatopa's down. Not even a two count. That just gives you the idea of that strength of Abbott again.
And the Reaper, no small man to push off.
Yeah, I mean,
then, oh my word.
I mean, the Reaper's easily fit 6 foot and built like a brick outhouse himself. And it is absolute, dear God, what a tilt-a-whirl slam that was. Oh, good lord, that was close. 2.9. And it's just absolutely dwarfed by Carl Abbott. Tag made. They do everything bigger in Scotland, it seems. Oh.
In a leg drop. Mysterio also just working on the legs of the Reaper here. Ooh, a chop. Fisherman suplex.
Beautiful Fisherman's. Just, again, that technical ability and speed, the strength for a guy his size. He is the full package, his low blow Mysterio. Also, quick tag made back to the big man. Abbott quite happy, it seems, to do the leg work.
Looking for a pin, but too close to those ropes.
This is a really good example of that unspoken kind of understanding between Abbott and Mysterio, so that they've shown so far every time they've teamed together.
Reaper blocked a kick out for another one of those face busters.
Oh, that was close. Two and a half again. Abbott now looking like he's starting to struggle a bit. The Reaper's done his job well here in just wearing the big man down.
Oh, look at the kiss of death.
It's interesting he used that move again that was originally created by Eli Ward.
But Joe Freeman.
Joe Freeman, yeah. Freeman and Ward were
really like leaving times.
It's a fair point actually, yeah. Freeman probably created it, then it was kind of adopted by Eli, and then the rest of the gang, if you will, started to use the maneuver. I wonder what Freeman thinks about that now he's back in action.
A face buster.
Tag made.
STF. STO. Oh.
Couple of dope at it now. Half shot there.
Cowboy Roy. Oh. Roy fighting free. Oh, hard clothesline.
Yeah, vicious clothesline there by the cowboy. Very meat and potatoes kind of wrestler. Old fashioned brawler. But again, farm strong.
Oh.
Dear Lord.
Carl Abbott just tag throwing made. Him around like a ragdoll. Oh. Lobo Mysterio also trying to block those shots of Roy. Roy just powering through the block. Even caught Abbott on the apron with one of those shots. Mysterioso now though. Oof. Shotgun drop kick.
Looks like Mysterioso busted open right there on that turnbuckle pad as well. So I think for the second match in a row, the cowboy is bleeding.
Abbott going for a pin.
This is where I worry about the cowboy. You know, he's on a full. Oh, Jesus, these stomps by Abbott. He's effectively working a full-time schedule again for the first time in years. And that wear and tear can get to the best of us.
Yeah, Roy has made the injury list a couple of times this month. Last month.
Oh, that's a cutter! And there you see it, that is the ability of Mysterio also to switch things up in a blink of an eye. Double axe handle breaks up the pin.
Very quick save by the Reaper there, and quick responses to catch Mysterio also, who's looking for vengeance there.
Chitopa quite rightly starting to count to get the Reaper out the ring. It's nice to see our senior official back in action.
Mysterio also, we saw this. Oh! Roy had the knees up though. Look at that people's moonsault. There's Lobo Mysterioso. Oh, that showboating cost him.
Tag made.
Reaper, the legal man again. Oh, that shot. Turned Lobo Mysterioso around. Oh, oh God. Dropping him.
It's just a torture act slam there. Nothing pretty about it, but certainly effective.
Why now? Lone Star.
Oh my word, the elevation there. Perfectly executed there by the Cowboy. Of course, Lobo doesn't weigh that much, so he was able to get that extra height. Abbott stayed on the ring apron there. Had faith in his partner, but he could be in trouble here, Mysterioso. Spear! Hell of a spear! Abbott's got to get in there now, surely. Oh no, Mysterioso kicks out on his own again!
Wow.
Now is that communication between Abbott and Mysterioso? And there's still a hell of a long way to go in this matchup.
Oh, spiking Hurricane Rana by Lobo Mysterioso. Tag to Carl Abbott. Oh, tag to the Reaper.
The fans are totally into this one, I mean. They love tag team wrestling here in NEW.
It's been 10 minutes of, over 10 minutes of absolute carnage here. Neither team with any give. Some very close falls on the Reaper.
Good Lord, Dominator! Well, that was impressive. We may have to put the Reaper in that strongest man competition, Erwin. That was insane.
That was incredible. Drags Hammer away from the ropes, looking for a pin.
Now we have to wonder if that extra second. Oof. Yeah, I was just speculating there. I mean, that extra second may have just saved Abbott from an inevitable three count, because not many people kick out of that Dominator. Oh. Great sidestep by Abbott there. Almost reading the Reaper's mind. Great recovery by the Big Scotsman. Tag made.
Lobo Mysterioso in after that big belly-to-belly. Anaconda Vice. Become a popular submission hold here in NEW as we wait. Oh, cranking back.
Well, yeah, it not only cuts off that airway, Erwin, of course, you're hurting those limbs as well, so it's almost like a double threat in terms of its submission, so I can see why guys have started to use it more here in NEW. Certainly now that, technical ability really is kind of...
Oh, shotgun dropkick.
Much more of a cornerstone of the company.
Straight into that pin.
Oh, there it is! Just like that!
I think Roy had only just got back.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right, Erwin. He'd only really just got back on the ring apron, but now the Cowboy is all on his own, and the Reaper's week has gone from bad to worse, because he is out of here.
Oh, Connor!
But he's already been busted open. Roy is clearly not 100%. Oh, my Lord! 2.9!
Serioso! Went for a big springboard splash, missed.
Yeah, went for the spectacular, but oh my, look how quick he countered Roy there.
Oh, Roy caught him.
Yeah,
oh.
Sheer power, powered out of it.
Oh, and again.
Great reflexes by the veteran there.
Roy has come alive here. Oh.
Well, I think he's just realised he's suddenly in a fight, Erwin. His tag team partner's gone, and Mysterioso and Abbott have arguably been one of the most impressive teams in this Summit tournament so far. This is going to be a long night at the office for the Cowboy, unless he gets an elimination fairly quickly.
Anaconda Vice. I think has that arm quite hooked in.
No, I would agree there, that right arm. Perhaps not quite in the right position. Mysterioso capitalized. Oof. Sends the Cowboy to the outside. A bit of showboarding there for Mysterioso. That's nothing new. Lobo. Oh!
Not sure how wise it is taking things to the outside with Cowboy Roy, though. Oof. No, and Mysterioso just found out why.
Yeah, it's just sheer pride from the Cowboy at this point. He's like, well, you want a fight, I'll give you a fight. I don't think Cowboy will care that his tag team partner has gone. He will fight tooth and nail, dear lord! Mysterioso's head was dangerously close to those steps then. Count of seven.
Three there.
Oh. One of these guys needs to get back into the ring quickly. Count of eight. Cowboy might get counted out here.
Now slides in behind Mysterioso, who once again showboarding, but returns with some chops. DDT.
You know, if he wasn't so talented, it would be infuriating. The amount of low bo- the amount that Lobo does showboard in that ring.
Again, finding three.
Oh,
side slam.
Right, I realise the stakes are high here, but it's in a 2-1 scenario. We've got like just under 14 minutes remaining.
Oh, 2.9, that was close.
That could have changed the entire dynamic of the matchup right there.
Oh, sweep leg by Mysterioso. Sent Roy into the corner.
You know, I would say, like, you know, retreat might be the better form of valor here, but it's just not in Roy's psyche.
Oh, another spiking Hurricane Rana. A tag made to Abbott, and that is exactly what Cowboy Roy wanted to avoid here.
Yeah.
Yeah, Globo Mysterioso well isolated. Oh.
Oh, no spear! Zero distance spear from absolutely nowhere! Two! Mysterioso saving his partner there. I'm not sure if Abbott would have got his shoulder up. The sheer power of that spear. Oh, holy hell!
Word! Lone Star Bomb!
That was insane. That the elevation in that Lone Star Bomb was exactly the same as it was with Mysterioso, and there's a notable size difference.
Looking for it again.
Spear! Beautiful spear. Textbook Roy. Not zero distance, but it did the job. Second one tonight for Carl Abbott. Mysterioso might want to get in there again, and he does. And this is why, this is exactly why we have been explaining Laurels, basically, about Carl Abbott and Lobo Mysterioso. They have really connected as a team, which makes this even harder for Roy.
12 minutes left on the clock. Roy has been fighting for his life here. Oh, Roy dumped to the outside.
Now you could argue that, you know, submissions aside, that may have been the best chance.
Oh my word!
The ground, Jesus Christ! That's just insane! Oof. No man should be able to do that. Oh, good lord! That's just this sinister belly of the back overhead. Just Cowboy just face first landing on those wafer thin mats.
Heading back out.
Abbott got back in the ring there, I think, to take a little bit of a breather, but then went right back on the assault. Oh, come on now.
Good God.
Oh, how many power bombs can one man take?
Oh,
sweet Jesus.
Way for thin mats hanging outside. Roy's still trying to fight back.
Might be sure how the Cowboy's conscious after all of that. There's been a hell of a lot of blood loss for the Cowboy as well. No way he's going to be 100% after this, win or lose. 10 minutes remain. Mysterioso back in the corner, and the Cowboy looks like he's in trouble.
Impressive spinning suplex there by Cowboy Roy. another Lone Star bomb.
He's getting the moves in, there's no doubt about it, but Abbott's there. And again, and
just saves him.
Only just.
Oof.
But this is what's making it doubly hard for the Cowboy. Even when he's hitting those power moves, he has to contend with that extra person there. He needs to take advantage of this while Abbott's not in his corner. Try and hit another power move and finish off Mysterioso and at least get this back to a one-on-one situation. A submission would do it. I literally cannot speak today.
And knees to the back.
Zero distance. This is it. This is it right here. Abbott's not going to make it two. Yes, one-on-one. Back to one-on-one.
There's Elf.
Well, Mysterioso and the Reaper is out. My pick's out for the summit. And it's come down to the Cowboy and Carl Abbott.
Carl Abbott with the advantage. Roy still trying to get to his feet after the pin. Got a boot and oof. Big splash. That's it.
God damn it. Let's be honest here. I mean, Roy was in an uphill battle there. He was basically in a 2-on-1 situation for at least 10 minutes.
Smash
all that weight, all that power, and Carl Abbott defeats a bleeding and battered Cowboy Roy. Mysterioso showing some sportsmanship there, despite the fact that he has been eliminated from the tournament. Abbott tips the nod to his partner there. So Carl Abbott, last man standing, Erwin, for Team 2.
The lone man for Team 2. Jake Richards and Tyler York, the two left for Team 4. Now Team 5 have the advantage, as the Barbed Wire Bats and Hannibal Jacobs remain as their three. Could be a minus Zach George, who was unfortunately eliminated. It could be a full win for Team 5 here if they play it right.
Oh yeah. Right, yeah, Team 5 have done very well in this tournament. Fox and Valentine safe for the women. So it's just a matter of time now. It's just as we weed out the rest of these men.
We will be back. Don't go anywhere. We are back.
It's scheduled for Untouchable.
Well, I'm running out of superlatives for Nancy Valentine, who note, please note, that it seems, so far at least, that she's coming down to the ring on her own. And let's hope that this is a one-on-one contest, because both these ladies are in tag teams. Valentine already won half of the tag team championship, as obviously her and Fox have solidified their spot for the summit, because they're the only women left. So it's just a matter now of just climbing those rankings in the world division. I've been saying it for a while, Erwin, at some point they're going to build a division on this girl's back. And I truly do believe that. It is only a matter of time.
That Women's World Championship, the only title left for Nancy Valentine to conquer. 490 days with the Women's Junior Championship. Currently on her fourth run with those tag team titles.
Which is a record in itself, I believe.
1,220 days. Second ever Women's Tag Team Champion. Holds the longest single and overall run of both junior and tag titles.
Of course she is. Ever pretend that either of these two guys go anywhere alone. Well, Melissa Sanchez might actually go down in all seriousness as one of the most improved competitors. Like, these two ladies have set their sights, it seems, on the tag team division, and they've taken that craft extremely seriously. Of course, this is singles action tonight for Melissa Sanchez, who has completely changed both her physical appearance and her style over the last 12 months to great advantage to her, it must be said.
Yes, certainly a lot of gym work has gone in. A lot of extra ring time in Hotel Payne. Sanchez, interestingly enough, only a year behind Nancy Valentine's entrance to the company.
I mean, it's not particularly relevant to this match, but there's been a lot of speculation that Sanchez and Sophia Robbins are a little bit more than just friends, but you know, that's their business. Here we go, 15 minutes on the clock.
Oh! Legwork of Melissa Sanchez. Devastating as of late.
Well, yeah, I mean, when she came into NEW, she certainly didn't have that power or that size. And yeah, as you said, Erwin, a hell of a lot of gym work. And those legs have just become a real asset for Melissa Sanchez. The Cuban missile always had a hell of a lot of potential. Submission early on, 40 seconds in the match.
Valentine almost caught off guard by that.
Yeah, I love how calm she kept though, Erwin. Like, she's not a rookie anymore, is Nancy Valentine. She's not a veteran either, but she's certainly got that in-ring experience factor on there. Sanchez here tonight. Nancy Valentine has almost made a career of those big match experiences. Melissa Sanchez not quite reached those heights yet, but has all the potential to do it.
Sweep of the leg there. Puts Nancy Valentine back in control. A submission of her own. Rings of Saturn.
Homage to Perry, of course. Big Radicals fan as a kid, Nancy Valentine.
Sanchez breaking free there. Some high elbows, side of the head. Blocked that leg though. High kick of her own, some hard forearms.
Well, you know how highly I rate Valentine Erwin, but I really don't think she should be getting into a fist fight with Melissa Sanchez. She needs to stick to what she knows. I don't think there's going to be any doubt about who's going to be the most powerful competitor in this match. And if Valentine tries to match her power to power, then that's going to be a bad course of action, in my opinion.
It's stretching Valentine out on the outside there. same time, though. Oh, strength of her own.
Yeah, no doubt. Heart of a lion as Nancy Valentine.
Send Sanchez back in.
And a talent of match. Oh, here we go.
Calf crusher.
Of course, Valentine does have a bit of a reputation as a submission specialist, as does her teacher and tag team partner, the Fox. And I find it interesting to see, like, the Fox not actually here tonight. Of course, still has aspirations in this division herself. But it's Valentine who's had the had that hot streak as of late.
Big suplex by Sanchez, who has been using that power health throughout this match here.
You know, as close as they are, the Fox and Nancy Valentine, you have to wonder if the Fox is actually ready for Nancy Valentine to maybe even surpass her and, you know, become Women's World Champion.
Insurance. I think that's perhaps why she's wanting to let Nancy Valentine prove she can do it on her own.
Well, I have absolutely no doubt that Valentine can do it on her own. No doubt whatsoever. If this match is stayed pure, then I'm sticking with my prediction that Valentine is the favourite here. No disrespect to Melissa Sanchez.
Oh!
Who has given out a great showing herself here tonight.
Can't get into a pin.
Yeah, great example of that leg strength. Only a one count, just that heart again of Valentine. Might be her biggest asset in that ring. Oh! It's one of many, folks. Melissa Sanchez, however, showing no intimidation. She has to keep on top of Valentine. Valentine taking advantage there.
Into the pin.
Sanchez hesitated. Valentine capitalized. 2.9.
Sweet
great line. Reversal.
Valentine out the back door, misses with a shot that closes in.
Such a competitive women's division right now. It's wonderful to see. Many a main event as of late, they have surpassed the men.
Valentine closing in from Valentine. Oh my word, what a knee strike. Oh, crossface.
Yeah,
modified
crossface there by Melissa Sanchez. I don't think she quite got that hook under the chin.
Valentine
allowed Valentine to get free. We've seen a couple of examples of that tonight, of submissions not quite working out the way the competitor wanted them to. I think a lot of these guys have started to do their homework with these submissions because they're being used so much more now in the company.
What a rennie again! Too close to the rope.
Yeah, I think that rope saved Valentine there.
Oh, that crisis terminal
there, beautiful. I think the ropes again are coming to play. Now Shatopa says it's okay.
Close, yeah, check off.
Referee had a great view of that, so.
That was close.
I think that's just a hard camera angle there.
Valentine on Dream Street here. More strikes from Sanchez. Top rope. Valentine coming around though. Kick to the back. Drop kick.
A bit of a flurry here by Valentine, who has been kicked from pillar to post by Melissa Sanchez. But gearing up, finding that second gear once again. Great power.
That leg strength again from Sanchez.
Yeah, it's like... Oh, dear God. I think Sanchez has realised that she does have that power advantage, and to her credit, is using that to full effect during this matchup.
Knees to the back. Valentine, as you say, Max, has just been beaten by Melissa Sanchez throughout this match. Oh, look at this! Athleticism from Sanchez. Ducks a clothesline. Oh. Caves in the legs of Valentine there. Oh. That's nearly enough. Oh. Bit of exploder. Oh, Crisis Terminada for a second time. That's it.
That is a huge win for Melissa Sanchez. And well earned, I would say. Like, Nancy Valentine fought valiantly. You know, we've got to give a little bit of credit to Sophia Robbins as well, who was completely impartial during this entire matchup. But that is an incredibly impressive win by Melissa Sanchez. I must admit, that shocked me there. That could arguably be the biggest win of Melissa Sanchez's career to date. In my opinion, that's a huge victory for the Cuban Missile.
Perhaps not what the people wanted to see here tonight, but...
I'm Reno Phillips, here at this time with Cowboy Roy. Roy, bad luck in the Summit Tournament.
What's with all these young boys wanting to retire in Reno? It's been a string of them lately. Tasmania, Paul Masters, now Abbott takes me out of the Summit. I'm sick of that lingering question of have I still got it? I'm about to remind everyone of why I'm a legend in New Extremes Wrestling.
Wow, a defiant couple of words there from the Cowboy, as you would expect. We're going to take a quick break.
I'm here at this time with Charlie Braddock. Charlie, I believe you have some news regarding Magnum Opus?
Indeed, Reno. You see, the leader himself, Rick Weaver, approached me quietly the other week and told me, Charlie, I'd love to have you on the team, but a man of such a caliber of your own would make Bruce Brown nervous, and I would feel bad about having to kick Morse out to be able to afford you the opportunities you so truly deserve. And speaking of what you deserve, the other two will never reach the heights of world champion, but you, Charlie, are special to this business. It would not be fair to ask you to step down while I was champion. I respected that, Rick. You're a good man. It's a shame we couldn't come to terms, but no hard feelings, eh?
Well, what the hell do you make of that?
That's very interesting revelations. Charlie Braddock.
The following contest is scheduled
While Tyler York, who has reinvented himself in this injection division, and he has one more match to go all the way against what has become one of his biggest rivals here, Sean O'Grady. Two veterans, two locker room leaders, and a relationship born from respect. It's going to be a hell of a matchup, Irwin.
It certainly is. Three five-minute rounds. 1 point for count out or disqualification awarded to you. 2 points for a draw. 3 points for a win. They're both tied at 16 points apiece here.
And let's not forget that O'Grady is holding it there in his hands, the golden ticket, which he can cash in on a championship of his choosing within their space of a year. So this could be arguably the most successful year in Sean O'Grady's career to date, but he has to get the job done. We're in two men right here in arguably the best form of their careers, going one-on-one in arguably one of our most contested divisions. One hell of a match here, mark my words. And here we go.
You see it, 16 points apiece, as I said. Not ready. Duking it out of here. Trapezius squeeze from Tyler York already.
Yeah, York has changed up his style a bit in this division, as has O'Grady. Both guys in phenomenal shape. And this is a hard one for me personally, because these are both great guys.
But both have been elevated by the injection division, in my opinion, this year. Had that game focus throughout this year. Both deserve the spot they're in right now.
Well, yeah.
Only one can face Alex Kromm.
I completely agree with all of that, Irwin. And you know, I think it's important to remember
that, dear Lord.
Both these guys weren't particularly favoured in this division when they decided to go for it, and now both these men stand as, you know, potential number one contender to arguably the best technical wrestler in the world. In Alex Kromm, and here we go. Like, it's just these two guys just trying to sound each other out right now. Hard hits from both men.
Furious pace to kick this first round off.
Yeah, I didn't really expect anything less. I think both guys know exactly what's at stake here, and obviously they've already had that match a few weeks ago, which did end up in a draw.
There's almost some trepidation here as to how this will unfold, what both men have adjusted in their attack, if you will, from the last match they had. Three rounds that went to a draw. Essentially saving his skin in that final round.
If I was forced to make a choice in this one, and again, as I said, it's a hard choice to make, but I'd probably pick York. I mean, O'Grady's already got that golden ticket. That's a guaranteed title shot this year. You could make the argument that York needs this more. Great snake eyes. Classic Tyler York. Big leg drop.
Going for the pin. Nearly had it there halfway through the first round.
The best thing about Tyler York this year for me is, like, he seemed to have finally learned that it doesn't have to be fancy, it just needs to get the job done.
Face buster.
8-year veteran is Tyler York.
Here since the first brawl.
Big power bomb. Two. Oh god, that was close. 2.9. It's God. It's I'm so conflicted, Erwin.
Oh great, it seems to be struggling to get out of the standing gear here against Tyler York.
Yeah, Tyler York has come in with laser focus, and you're absolutely right.
This round.
But you know, let's not, you know, all the O'Grady fans out there need not panic yet, because we've seen the big Irishman come back from so many positions like this over the last year. Like, I have always said and believed that O'Grady's one of those competitors. He needs to get beat up a little bit before he really starts fighting.
And elbows from Tarry York. Quite right, Max, that steam train ability of O'Grady is what favours him in the injection division's round system. Oh. He's fighting back here.
And you know, it's important to remember as well that O'Grady's been fighting his entire adult life. You know, he knows how to take a punch, there's no doubt about that. I'd say undoubtedly one of the toughest guys, legitimately one of the toughest guys in our locker room. It's Sean O'Grady.
Where Tarry York just unfolding with gut shots here. Hard shot to the back.
But you could make that same argument, that same claim about Tarry York, which is what makes this matchup all the more intriguing. 5 seconds on the clock. This is almost certainly going to a draw.
O'Grady.
Yeah, first round draw.
Couldn't quite get that submission locked in time.
So is that 2 points apiece, Erwin?
That is 2 points apiece. Still tied. Yep. Still heading toward that sudden death, but rounds two and three before that.
Well, I would say for the most part of that round, Tarry York had the advantage, but O'Grady definitely did start to regroup near the end of that round, so a tale of two halves perhaps in the first 5 minutes. As we look at the replays here, these two guys just knocking the snot out of each other. Look at these rights and left by York, those body shots.
And I believe this is the first time ever the sudden death has had to be used to find a number one contender. It's usually reserved for the champion to decide whether he wants it on the defense of his championship match. Go second round, 18 points apiece now on the board for these two. Chitopa rings the bell and we have another 5 minutes. Oh, very quick to dodge that first shot. Tarry York though, quick to catch up again. Oh, hard shot to that knee again. Tarry York, oh, looking for a Boston Crab. Couldn't quite turn O'Grady there, but has it locked in? Oh. O'Grady powering out. And now may have a chance. Waiting in that corner. For a bow, no. Tarry York got out of the way.
Yeah, sidesteps it. You don't see that often. That's a great example, I think, there of Tarry York doing his homework. Being as prepared as possible for this matchup. That Furabala generally connects.
Hard shot to the back from Tarry York. Looking for it, that elevated powerbomb. Oh, too close to the ropes. O'Grady's arm.
I think, you know, I would say that you knew Crom better than I did, Erwin. Do you think he's got a preference for who he would rather face?
I don't think Crom cares, as long as it's a hard fought match, as long as he comes out of it with bruises on him, but still that championship around his waist. I don't think Crom cares. Crom just looks for a good fight, a good challenge to his throne.
Well, yeah, I think either of these men would give him exactly that. Oh, this has been a hard-fought affair these first two rounds. I mean, again, it's not been anything fancy. It's just been these two guys beating the holy hell out of each other. Oh!
O'Grady having a bit more offense in the second round, but Tarry York once again taking control. Big boot.
And that little flurry, that classic Tarry York action, the snake eyes into the big boot, into the leg drop. He tried this in round one. He's tried it again. Oh, and it's almost yielded his yielded results, 2.9.
Driving the head into the canvas. Like there.
Duff. Great snap suplex right into the pin rope break.
Close to the ropes. Thought she took it. I hadn't seen it for a moment there.
It takes a lot to get past good old Mike. After the free match card tonight, he's not going to be happy.
Oh. Big back body drop by O'Grady, avoiding whatever it was. Tally York had him wait. Oh, big DDT. Looking for a pin.
Well, the good news is it means he's getting extra money tonight, so he's buying the G&Ts later. Go on, O'Grady.
Back in the corner once more. No! Oh, connects this time.
That could be it. Clear the way, my word. Oh. 2.9, somehow York gets his shoulder up. O'Grady thinks that's a free. Chitopa's having none of it.
Of course, that sudden death, which is looking, oh, ever closer, face buster. Around Tyler York, thinking that might be enough. Oh. That sudden death has no time limit. The way these two are going, they may very well fight into the night, into the dawn, into the next day. Elevated sit-out powerbomb by Tyler York.
Yeah, that's just a beautiful powerbomb. It's been a get-out-of-jail-free card.
And
there it is. There it is.
But well, we remember... Last time, Tyler York did get the victory in the second round. O'Grady clawed it back in the third.
Well, yeah, it's 5-2 now, so O'Grady has to win this third round to bring it to sudden death. If my maths is right, Irwin.
Correct,
so
yeah.
This is an all or nothing round for O'Grady. I would say O'Grady in this second round, as you said, had a lot more of the offense than he did in the first, but Tyler York just pulled it back with that elevated powerbomb, which has been such a big factor in his revival this year.
I think I know what York approached. I think Tyler York just seems a little step faster here tonight. I think he's been working on his reactionary skills. Just that overall speed. Over that strength, he's not really displayed as much strength as he usually does.
The fact that Tyler York can still improve his game after 8 years in is just an incredible feat to me.
21-18, there's the scores. Some phenomenal heights these two have clawed to. Oh, with those points this year.
Yeah, it's been a great division. One of the best ideas I think the committee's had in some time is the injection division. It's really revitalized careers. Oh!
Suplex there.
All the guys in the back want bragging rights in this division because it's so hotly contested.
Oof. Big elbow drop. And again.
You know, the European title has always traditionally been the workhorse title here in NEW, but I would say, oh, we're having it pinned here. I would say the injection division is giving that title a run for its money right now.
Oh, swing blade. Tyler York again, quick back to his feet, already quick to respond, sends him out to the apron. Oh, big drop kick sends Tyler York to the outside.
Yeah, hard landing for York. He's had one or two of those in his career, no doubt. O'Grady keeping the high ground for the moment, but now following Tyler York to the outside. Oof. And this could get nasty very quickly. But O'Grady knows he needs the points in this round to push it to sudden death. A draw will not do it. It is win or bust for Sean O'Grady. 3 minutes and 20 seconds to get it done. Tyler York, an act of defiance there after the beatdown on the outside.
Nice shot. Oh, and a boot.
Well, we know there's a huge amount of respect between these guys.
Certainly.
It's been well documented. O'Grady and Tyler York. You know, they came here for a good, honest fight, and that's exactly what we're seeing.
Trapezius Squeeze tried this early on in the first round.
I'm really not so sure who the fans want to win this either, you know what I mean? Both these guys are pretty firm fan favourites.
Seems to be equal applause for both of them.
It does.
To the top rope. Oh, talent drop.
It is almost 50-50. It's I very rarely see that.
Back here.
Oh, good lord, that was so close. O'Grady was a half a second away, less than that, for squaring things up and sending this to sudden death. Oh, wait a minute. Might be looking for it again. For a power. There it is. Lord.
Tyler York somehow, some way kicking out there.
This is insane. Good lord, hard chopped.
Oh, LA kick.
Just a really impressive athleticism as well by O'Grady Irwin. It's just for a guy his size.
Certainly. On that submission lock he was looking for. That clover leaf. Didn't quite have the time last time, but now has over a minute to torture Tyler York.
Ah, the old four leaf clover from O'Grady. It's going to wear down the leg strength of Tyler York, no doubt. He was never going to submit, I don't think. I think he would have passed out before he tapped out. I think that's how much Tyler York wants this one.
Oh, fan to the arm. An elbow drop.
Right, all York really has to do is stay out of trouble now. We've got less than a minute remaining, but you just know Tyler York is just not going to stop fighting until that bell rings.
Yes, Buster.
He wants an emphatic victory over O'Grady. He wants to solidify his contendership. He wants to make sure everybody knows that he is the man coming for Alex Krom. Is this the moment? Two! No! That was close.
Shatopa eagerly-eyed on this battle.
That's exactly what it's been, Irwin.
York looking for it again.
There's still time here.
Elevated sit out.
It's hooked into
the
pin.
Of the ring.
Oh, this is going to be close. Oh! The bell rang. I don't think O'Grady.
York has gone through.
Yeah, I don't think O'Grady was kicking out of that, but he ran out of time. You're absolutely right. Tyler York, number one contender for the injection division. What a brawl that was. No pun intended.
Yeah. What a main event. Tyler York will go on to face Alex Krom at Nightmare before New Year. We have a little bit of road before we reach that. So we will see you next time. Thank you and good night.